Guys, my topic is supposed to be edema and acute kidney disease. Edema is a very common manifestation, as everybody knows, in renal disease. We presume to know the pathophysiology, but indeed, it is evolving. And molecular things are coming around, and we come to recognize that edema by itself is not a homogeneous pathophysiology. We're going to discuss the basis of having interstitial edema. I'm not going to discuss pulmonary edema and how it develops in the fundamental way, as well as the secondary factors that cause the development. As I said, some molecular factors, currying, are being promoted as a possible cause of this increased salt retention. Then we'll discuss the different edema and its pathophysiology in the different diseases, starting from nephrotic syndrome, which has actually several pathophysiology, then to nephritic syndrome, AKI and edema in cardiac disease, liver cirrhosis, burns, and a lot of other diseases. We will then approach the treatment of edema. As you well know, the edema treatment by itself is mostly aesthetic. Nobody has really died from edema in the legs or in the interstitium, but we can get the secondary effect. We will try to discuss the treatment of edema among the different situations that I mentioned, as they have different pathophysiology, and therefore we will have a different approach and treatment strategy for each one. See you in the PSN 39th Annual Convention.